Spirit of Truth, who are present everywhere and filling all things, the treasure of blessings and source of life, come, abide in us, cleansed of all stain, and save our souls, O good one.
Amen. Holy God, Holy Mike, Holy Lord, have mercy on us. I was of Theos, I was of Heroes, I was of Power of Salvation in us. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Lord, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, but now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. O Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Lord, forgive our sins. Master, pardon our transgressions. Cover with and heal our infirmities for your name's sake.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever and the ages of ages.
Save me, O my God, for you struck all those who were foolishly at enmity with me. You broke the teeth of sin. and your blessings upon your people. I lay down and slept, I awoke, for the Lord will help me.
O Lord, do not rebuke me in your wrath, nor test me in your anger. For your hours are fixed in me, and your hand rests on me. There's no healing in my flesh because of your wrath. There's no peace in my bones because of my sins. For my transgressions rise up over my head. Like a heavy burden, they are heavy for me. My wounds grow foul and fester because of my fault. I suffer misery, and I am utterly bowed down. I go all the day long with a set face, for my loins are filled with migraines, and there's no healing in my flesh. I'm afflicted and greatly humbled. I roar because of the glory of my heart. O Lord, all my desires before you, and my glory is not hidden from you. My heart is troubled, my strength fails me, and the light of my eyes, even this, is not with me. My friends and neighbors draw near and stand against me, and my near kin stand far off. And those who seek my soul use violence, and those who seek evil for me speak folly. And they meditate on deceit all the day long. But I'm like a deaf man, do not hear, and I'm like a mute who does not open his mouth. I'm like a man who does not hear, and who has no reproof in his mouth. For in you, O Lord, I hope. You will hear, Lord my God, for I said, let not my enemies rejoice over me. For when my foot is shaken, they boast against me. For I am ready for wounds, and my pain is continually with me. For I will declare my transgressions, and I will be anxious about my sin. But my enemies sleep, and I become stronger than I am. And those who hate me unjustly are multiplied. Those who repay me evil for good slander me, because I pursue righteousness. And they throw away my mouth, as it was we were a stinking corpse. Do not forsake me, O Lord. O my God, do not depart from me. Keep him to help me, O Lord, of my salvation. Do not forsake me, O Lord. O my God, do not depart from me. Keep him to help me, O Lord, of my salvation.
O Lord, my God, I rise early to be with you, and my soul thirsts for you. How often my flesh thirsts for you in a desolate, impassable, and waterless land. So the holy place I appear before you to see your power and your glory. Because your mercy is better than life, my lips shall praise you. Thus I will bless you in my life. I will lift up my hands in your name. May my soul be filled as if with marrow and fatness, and my mouth shall sing praise me with lips filled with rejoicing. If I remember you on my bed and meditated on my daybreak, for you are my helper, and in the shelter of your wings I will greatly rejoice. My soul follows close behind you, your right hand makes hope of me. But they seek for my soul in vain, and they shall go into the lowest parts of the earth, and they shall be given over to the edge of the sword. There shall be a portion for foxes. But the king shall be glad in God, and all who swear by him shall be praised, for the mouth that speaks unrighteous things is stopped. I meditated on you at daybreak, for you are my helper, and in the shelter of your wings I will greatly rejoice. My soul follows close behind you, and your right hand takes hold of me. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto ages and ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to your God. Alleluia, 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 glory to your God. Alleluia, 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 glory to your God. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto ages and ages. Amen.
Lord God of my salvation, I cry day and night before you. Let my prayer come before you. Incline your ear to my supplication, O Lord. For my soul is filled with sorrows, and my soul draws near to Hades. I'm counting among those who are down to the pit. I'm like a helpless man, free among the dead. Like slain men thrown down and sitting in a grave, whom you remember no more. But they are removed from your head. They lay in a lost pit, dark places in the shadow of death. Your wrath rested upon me, and you brought all your bills over me. You removed acquaintances apart from me that made me an abomination among themselves. I was betrayed and did not go forth. My eyes weakened for power, your Lord. I cried to you the whole day long. I spread out my hands to you. Will you work wonders for the dead? Or will physicians raise them up and acknowledge you? Shall anyone in the grave describe your mercy and your truth in destruction? Shall your workers be known in darkness and your righteousness in a forgotten land? But I cry to you, O Lord, and in the morning my prayer shall come near you. Why, O Lord, do you reject my soul and turn away your face from me? I am hurt and I am troubled. For my youth, heaven be exalted, I was humbled and brought up into despair. You fierce anger rest over me, and you terrors right in trouble. They compassed me like waters all the day long. They surrounded me at once. You removed far from me neighbor and friend, and my acquaintances because of my misery. O Lord God of my salvation, I cry day and night before you. Let my prayer come before you. Incline your ear to my supplication, O Lord.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and everything within me bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his rewards, who is merciful to all your transgressions, who heals all your diseases, who redeems your life from corruption, who crowns you with mercy and compassion, who satisfies your desire for good things, and your youth is renewed like the eagles. The Lord shows mercies and judgment to all who are wrong. He made known his ways to Moses, the things he will to the sons of Israel. The Lord is compassionate and merciful, slow to anger and abounding in mercy. He will not become angry to the end, nor will he be wrathful forever. He did not deal with us according to our sins, nor reward us according to our transgressions. For according to the height of heaven from earth, so the Lord reigns in mercy over those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so he removes our transgressions from us. As a father's compassion on his children, so the Lord has compassion on those who fear him. For he knows how he formed us, members that we are dust. As for man, his days are like grass, as a flower of the field, so it flourishes. For the wind passes over it, and it shall not remain. It shall no longer know its place. But the mercy of the Lord is from age to age upon those who fear him, and his righteousness upon children's children, to such as keep his covenant and remember his commandments to them. The Lord prepared his throne in heaven, and his kingdom rules over all. Bless the Lord, all you his angels, mighty and strange, through his word, so as to hear the voice of his words. Bless the Lord, all you his hosts, his ministers, who do his will. Bless the Lord, all you his works in all places of his dominion. Bless the Lord, my soul, and how he knows what his will is, and what will you give him.
O Lord, hear my prayer. Give ear to my supplication in your truth. Answer me in your righteousness. Do not enter into judgment of your servant, for no living shall become righteous in your sight. For the enemy persecuted my soul, he covered my life to the ground. Because to dwell in dark places as one more dead, and my spirit was in anguish unto me, my heart was troubled unto me. I remember the days of old, and I meditate on all your works. I meditate on the works of your hands. I spread out my hands to you, my soul thirsts for you like a waterless land. Hear me speedily, O Lord. My spirit faints within me. Turn not your face from me, lest I become like those who were down in the pit. Cause me to hear your mercy in the morning, for I hope in you. Let me know, O Lord, the way wherein I should walk, for I lift up my soul to you. Deliver me from my enemies, O Lord, for to you I have been for refuge. Teach me to do your will, for you are my God. Your good spirit shall guide me in the land of uprightness. For your name's sake, O Lord, give me life in your righteousness. You shall bring my soul out of affliction, and in your mercy you shall destroy my enemies. You shall utterly destroy all who afflict my soul, for I am your servant. Answer me in your righteousness. Do not enter into judgment of your servant. Answer me in your righteousness. Do not enter into judgment of your servant. Your good spirit shall guide me in the land of uprightness. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to you, God. Alleluia, 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 glory to your God. Alleluia, 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 glory to your God. Our hope, O Lord, glory to you.
In peace let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the stability of the holy churches of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, and for those who enter it with faith, reverence, and godly fear, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For pious and orthodox Christians, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this country, the president and all in public service, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city and for every city and land, and for the faithful who live in them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For fair weather and abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who travel by land, sea, and air, for the sick, the suffering, the captives, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and distress, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by your will.
Lord,
commemorating our most holy, pure, and blessed, and glorious day, the Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
Would you, O Lord,
for you belong all glory, honor, and worship to the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever and to the ages of ages.
Amen. God is the Lord, and He revealed Himself to us. Blessed is He who comes in the name of the Lord.
Give thanks to the Lord for all His holy name.
God is the Lord, and He revealed Himself to us. Blessed is He who comes in the name of the Lord.
All the nations surround me, but the name of the Lord, I defend myself against them.
God is the Lord, and He revealed Himself to us. Blessed is He who comes in the name of the Lord.
Something about the Lord is wonderful in our eyes.
God is the Lord, and He revealed Himself to us. Blessed is He who comes in the name of the Lord. Dulithus praedis ternos in hoponium verum, cestra dio cofila stontum noarca gosu soma, amestis primero sotir, lorumen nostro cosmotis dohin, dia tuto et in nomis domura non, e vos is domota. Doxa fiam las passis cum Christe, doxa ti basilios tum, doxa ti economios cum mole filat pro.
Secured with the seal by the Judeans, and a guard of soldiers white sheep revived in the valley. You rose on the third day, O Lord and Savior,
spacious than the heavens. Glory to him who dwelt inside of you. Glory be to him who came forth from you. Glory be to him who through your childbirth has set us free.
Again and again, peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Commemorate your most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints. Let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
Through you, O Lord.
For yours is the dominion, and yours is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Men, the soldiers keeping watch at your tomb, O my Savior, became as dead for fear of the radiant angel, and he proclaimed that you arose to the women who came at dawn. We extolled you, Lord, for you abolished corruption, and we worship you, our only God, who was buried and rose from the sepulchre.
Δόξα πατρί Θεό και Άγιο Πνεύματι, τον Σταυρό προσήλωτης εκουσίως εκτήρμων εν πνήματι τέτης ως πνητός οδόντα το κράτος συνέτριψας δυνατέ το θανάτο σου σε κατέφρυξαν οι πληροί του Άδου σύ συνήγυρας του απαιώνος θανόντος ως σκόπος φιλάνθρωπος.
Both Lord Heaven to the ages of ages, amen. All we who run to you and with longing take refuge in your benevolence, know that you are our mother of God and laughter, giving birth for a virgin in very truth. For we sinners have you as our only protection. In temptation, we rely on you for salvation.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. When you, the life of the universe, were nailed unto the cross, and you were reckoned among the dead, O Lord, the immortal one. O Savior, on the third day you arose, and resurrected Adam from decay. For this
despotu dorkion anastis onimas petrokotas is chaos vinis apogloseos και πνευμάτων και θλίψεων, σίγα και έφυγας, αμαρτωλών σωτηρία και βοήθεια και κρατεά προστασία και σώσεις τους δούλους σου.
And ever Virgin Mary with all the saints. Let us commend ourselves unto one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
To you, O Lord.
For blessed is your name and glorified is your kingdom, of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now
establish them in salvation.
and we will give glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen. You arose from the sepulchre, inglorious God, and with yourself resurrected the world. In mortal name extolled you as God, in death is obliterated, and Adam is dancing. O Master, and Eve, now redeemed from the bonds, rejoices, crying out, O Christ, you are he who grants resurrection to all.
Let us extol as omnipotent God, the one who rose on the third day, and who smashed the gates of Hades, and who raised from the tomb those who were there for all time, and who was seen by the murmuring women as he so willed, uttering to them first of all the greeting, rejoice, and to the apostles declaring the joy as the only giver of life. Therefore, in faith, the women announce to the disciples the tokens of victory. And Hades groans, and death laments, and the world exalts all people rejoice together. For you, O Christ, are he who grants resurrection to all.
Let us flee the Pharisees, exalting powers. Let us learn the publicans, humble demeanor, and with signs go to the Savior, cry out and say, to us be gracious, holy, forgiving Lord.
Sinners, let us fall before the Lord and Master in prayer, as once the publican. Let us present him our sign. He desires that all humanity gain salvation, and to all workers who are repentant, he grants forgiveness. He became a man for our sake, though the Father without beginning is God.
Brethren, let us guard ourselves in lowliness, and with laments and sighs strike our conscience, that as the judgment then, which is in perpetuity, we shall be viewed guiltless, attain our impunity. For there we have true mitigation. To see it, let us make supplication. For there is pain and sorrows unceasing, gone in deep sighs, there in wondrous Eden, of which Christ was fashioned, he being with the Father without beginning, as God.
On February 13, in memory of the Our Father Martinian, on this day we also commemorate the holy apostle and martyr Aquila and Priscilla. On this day we also commemorate our devout father and warriors, Archbishop of Alexandria. On this day our father and son died by crucifixion. On this day we remember the parable of the publican and the Pharisee, of the Holy Gospel of the Evangelist Luke.
A single man, stay away from the temple, for Christ is therein, where he accepts the humble. O Creator of all earth and in heaven, as you receive the thrice holy hymn from the angels, so also accept the trio young from us humans. By the intercession of your saints, who have done great things, O Christ and God, have mercy on us and save us. Amen.
When they had walked through the Red Sea as over land, the people of
from a mind that has been pure.
when my life becomes rough and stormy like the sea, temptations feel like the turbulence. So I turn to the safe harbor of your church and call me and pray to you. Raise my life from corruption, very merciful Lord.
Prosa Paul, Medicamento, Igasato, Angelosios, Ispesi, Dus Haveus de Cataflego. Πρόσταγμα Θεού, το δύναμον επίστευα, ευλογητώσει ο Θεός, ο των Πατέρων ημών.
We praise and we bless and we worship the Lord. From the name you refresh by a servant as with you, and with water consume the righteous prophet. Sacrifice. You accomplish all of Christ simply by giving in. We exalt you beyond measure unto all the earth.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
My sin is always with me. Against you only have I sinned and and that evil in your sight, that you be justified in the words that have come from your judge. For behold, I was conceived in transgression, and it sins my mother bore me. Behold, you love truth. You showed me the unknown and secret things of your wisdom.
You shall sprinkle me with kisses, and I will be cleansed. You shall wash me, and I will be made white as snow. You shall make me hear joy and gladness. My bones that were humbled shall greatly rejoice. Turn your face away from my sins and blot out all my transgressions. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Do not cast me away from your presence. Do not take your Holy Spirit from me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation and uphold me with your guiding spirit. I will teach transgressors your ways, and your godly shall turn back. Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God, the God of my salvation. My tongue shall break the spirit of righteousness. O Lord, you shall open my lips, and my mouth shall declare your praise. For if you desire sacrifice, I would have given it, but it will not be pleased with whole burnt offerings. Be sacrificed to God as a broken spirit, a broken and humble heart, God will not despise. Do good, O Lord, in your good pleasure to Sion, and let the walls of Jerusalem be built. And you will be pleased with the sacrifice of righteousness, and with offerings of whole burnt offerings. And they shall offer young calves on your altar, and have mercy on you above.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Άγιο Πνεύματι, εις μετανοίας άνοιξον η πύλα σου οδότα, αρχίζειγα το πνεύμα μου προς λαό των Άγιων σου, ναόν φέρου του σώματος, όλων εσφυλωμένων, αλλώς η κτήρων κάθαρων εσπάρχου σου ελέγει.
Nicholas, Bishop of Myra, Spiritual Bishop of Tunituos, and Darius of Pentapolis, the water workers, the holy, glorious, great martyrs, George, the victorious, Demetrius, the Marmolites, Theodore the Tyrant, and Theodore the General, Menas the water worker, the hieromartyrs, Cronus and Eleftherios, the holy, glorious, and victorious martyrs, the glorious, great martyr, and all Lord of Euphemia, the holy and glorious martyrs, Stepna, Barbara, Anastasia, Catherine, Kiriakif, Otini, Marina, Paraskivi, and Irene. Of our holy God, the fathers, the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, and the holy saints, we beseech you, only merciful Lord, hear us, hear us, and pray to you, and have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
And the glory breaker, be your compared and the set of peace.
Praise God.
Here.
Comforter, the Spirit of Truth, who are present everywhere and feeding all things, the treasure of blessings and source of life, come, abide in us, cleanse us of all stain and save our souls, O good one. Heavenly King Comforter, the Spirit of Truth, who are present everywhere and feeding all things, the treasure of blessings and source of life, come, abide in us, cleanse us of all stain, and save our souls, O good one. Heavenly King Comforter, the Spirit of Truth, who are present everywhere and feeding all things, the treasure of blessings and source of life, come, abide in us, cleanse us of all stain, and save our souls, O good one. Glory to God in the highest heaven, and peace on earth to them who enjoy His favor. Glory to God in the highest heaven, and peace on earth to them who enjoy His favor. Lord, open my lips, and my mouth will speak out Your praise. Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
In peace let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
ασέντων φρόνων αυτού και η βασιλεία αυτού πάντων δεσπόζει.
Χριστούς αιώνας, τον αιώνα. and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
To you, O Lord.
For you are the loving God, and we give glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Glory.
După trei tuiuri de codiune fumate, Cristus pune ona,
the Lord said this parable. Two men
went up into the temple to pray, one a Pharisee and the other a tax collector. The Pharisee stood and prayed thus with himself, God, I thank you that I am not like other men, extortioners, unjust, adulterers, or even like this tax collector. I fast twice a week. I give tithes of all that I get. But the tax collector, standing far off, would not even lift up his eyes to heaven, but beat his breast, saying, God, be merciful to me, a sinner. I tell you, this man went down to his house justified rather than the other, for everyone who exalts himself will be humbled, but he who humbles himself will be exalted.
Glory to you, Lord. Glory to you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. There was a rich landowner who one spring cleared all of his land, and he decided to give freedom to his three servants, and not only to give freedom to them, but to give them his land. He divided his clear, beautiful land between his three servants. He summoned them and he told them, you are free now, my land is yours. Do whatever you want to do with it. One of them greatly rejoiced, but he couldn't care less about the gift he was given. Soon enough, with the spring and the summer coming, his land was full of weeds, and it was a very unpleasant sight for the entire village. Another of the servants decided to plant the most beautiful garden. And he started to work with a lot of pride and enthusiasm because he wanted to have the most beautiful garden of the village. By summer, he was having a beautiful garden and he was very proud of his garden. And he was boasting to everyone in the village how beautiful his garden was. But everyone in the village, they were impressed with the garden, but not with him. Because he became a very proud and boastful man. The third one greatly rejoiced when he heard the news of his freedom and that now he's going to have his own piece of land. He thanked the master. He was praying every day for him. And he started to work that very day. He planted a beautiful garden because he wanted this garden to be a beautiful sight for the other people in the village. He made alleys in the garden so that the people could come in and walk through the garden and enjoy it. And when the fruit was ready, he kept barely anything for himself and his family, just enough for himself and his family to survive. And he gave the fruit of the garden to the people of the village.
who of course were very thankful and loved him. I'm telling you this parable today because today is the beginning of our preparation for Pascha. Today, on the 10th Sunday before Pascha, we start in the life of the church the so-called time of the Triodion. It is a time of preparation for Pascha. We have 3 weeks of preparation for Great Lent, and then we go into, of course, Holy Week and Pascha. And like the three men in the Gospel, from what I'm noticing, that's where most Orthodox Christians are. Like one of the three men. Many Orthodox Christians rejoice at Pascha. They eat and drink and have a good time, but they couldn't care less about the garden, about the land of their heart that was freed by God and given to them to be turned into a beautiful garden. And soon enough, their heart is taken over by weeds of any kind of passions and distractions and worries. Some other Orthodox Christians want to have the beautiful garden. They get involved in ascetical practices of praying, fasting, reading the Bible, and giving alms, but just because, like the Pharisee in today's Gospel, they want to be observed by the people around them and to feel good about how good Orthodox Christians they are and to receive praise from people. Unfortunately, if this is our understanding of Great Lent and preparation for Pascha, if this is our understanding of this Lenten spring, at the end of the summer, even if we are going to have a beautiful garden that we are very proud of, many people are going to say, thank you very much, but I don't want to be close to you. Because even if we have beautiful deeds and long prayers and everything, we become very proud. And nobody wants to be close to a proud person. And there are a few who understand what Great Lent is about, who understand that in the spring, our Master, to whom everything belongs, decided to give freedom to us by giving his life for us. And we're to be thankful to him, and he gave us this beautiful land to work on it together with him and to share the fruit and to go to the next level of life. To go into the promised land of freedom, to go together with Christ into the new Jerusalem. That's what we are celebrating on Palm Sunday. Our entrance, my entrance with Christ into the new Jerusalem. So that by summer, by the descent of the Holy Spirit upon us, we have fruits to share with our community. When we go into the land of the apostles, we have fruits to share with the people of our city. And people would say, at Holy Trinity Greek Orthodox Church, they have beautiful people. They have people who know the gift of God, who appreciate the gift of God, who are not proud of who they are or of their ascetical practices, but who are humble and working together with God. At Holy Trinity, they have new and resurrected people. I want to be like the people of Holy Trinity Greek Orthodox Church. It is our choice. It is our very personal decision which one of the three men we want to be this spring. Amen. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Power, we give glory to you, the
Let
Let us love one another, so that with one mind we may confess.
Amen. Have mercy on me.
and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
without the shedding of blood, and we ask, pray, and entreat you. Send down your Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts you presented, and make this bread a precious body of your Christ.
Amen.
And that it is in this cup the precious blood of your Christ.
Amen.
Changing them by your Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
So that they may be with those who partake of them for vigilance of soul, forgiveness of sins, communion of your Holy Spirit, fulfillment of the kingdom of heaven, confidence before you, and not in judgment or condemnation. Again, we offer this spiritual worship for those who repose in the faith, forefathers, fathers, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, preachers, evangelists, martyrs, confessors, ascetics, and for every righteous spirit made perfect in faith. Especially for our most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary,
who in this proud heart of all you bless, ever blessed,
as an offering of spiritual fragrance. sinners, may in return see the past divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray.
Отче наш, който си на небесата, да се свети Твоето име, да дойде Твоето царство, да бъде Твоята воля както на небето, така и на земята. Насъщния ни хляб дай ни днес и прости нам дълговете ни, така както и ние прощаваме на дължниците си. И не ни довежди в изкушение, но избави от лука.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be Thy name, Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Now and forever, and the ages of ages.
Amen.
Hear me, Pasi, peace be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us bow our heads.
Oh,
Great. Prosélfete, approach with fear of God, with faith and with love. Those of you who are Orthodox and have prepared yourselves for receiving Holy Communion, please approach, beginning with our Sunday school students and teachers, and then with all of you. And as you come, I'm going to ask you to do two things. What? What is the first one?
Sing.
Sing. And the other one? Open your mouth. As wide as you can. Please come.
Thank you.
Christ, our true God, who is risen from the dead, as a good, loving, and merciful God, have mercy on us and save us. Through the intercessions of His most pure and holy Mother, the power of the precious and life-giving cross, the protection of the armor, bodiless force of heaven, the supplications of the armor, glorious prophet from the John the Baptist, the holy, glorious, and praiseworthy apostles, the holy, glorious, and triumphant martyrs, our holy and God-bearing fathers, the holy and righteous ancestors, Joachim and Anna, of St. Martinian, the righteous of Palestine, and the holy apostles, Aquila and Priscilla, whose memory we commemorate today, and of all of the saints.
It was, by the grace of God, more men came, and we had a very
productive get-together, we chose a new name for the group. We are now Brothers in Christ. And we also decided what we want to accomplish and the structure of our meetings. And also for the man who could not make it for this Monday's, for this month's get-together of the Brothers in Christ, but we are interested in this ministry. Also, I also want to let you know that we decided to read together the book, The Mount of Silence, by Kyriakos Martinez. And from now on, every time we get together, we are going to discuss one chapter. So we are going to read only one chapter a month, and when we get together and we eat and we have our fellowship, and then we do our work, for a few minutes we are going to discuss a chapter of the book, The Mount of Silence, by Kyriakos Martinez. The Parish Council is organizing a party on Saturday, February 26th. For more information and details, please see Drew or Jackie. Save these dates in your calendars. Wednesday, March 2nd, between 7 and 8 p.m., we are going to have, God willing, the second metropolis-wide webinar about transformative Christianity. And this time, we are going to have a talk with Father Anthony Cook about our relationship with food. It's a big one. It's a big one, but I also want to tell you that it is a beginning one. Our relationship with food is important, but it is at the beginning of our spiritual journey. And the Man of God movie about the life of St. Nectarius of Egina will be shown at Regal Cinemas Coldwater Crossing on Monday, March 21st at 7 p.m. I know the website doesn't sell tickets yet. We'll have to look more into that. I was like, and you know, talking about this because I was thinking, I'm afraid that if we are leaving it, you know, to buy our own tickets, we are not going to get our tickets. And I was thinking about, so they offer the option of buying tickets for a group of at least 25 people. Now, my fear is that I don't want to buy 25 tickets and to be left with 10, and then I'll have to pay for them. Okay? I'm okay to pay for the 25, as far as I know that you want to go. So how many people, I just want to see, you know, to see the feeling. How many people would be interested in watching this movie about St. Nectarius of Egina on Monday, March 21st? Please raise your hand. Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much. I'll try to get 25 tickets to get a group ticket. Jackie, you say no? Okay, thank you, Jackie. We'll see what we could do, you know, to be able to watch that movie. And on Tuesday and Friday morning, our senior men will get together for the men's club. Our ladies will get together for women's agape on Thursday morning at 10 a.m. And on Wednesday evening at 5 p.m., we'll have the Agape service followed by our Bible study and by questions and answers. On Tuesday evening at 6:30 p.m., we'll have a meeting of the Parish Council, and then God willing, next Sunday, we'll get together for the Sunday of the Prodigal Son, and we'll start the service at Matins at 8:45 a.m. and the Holy Liturgy at 10 a.m., followed by Sunday School and by the presentation done by Jeff and Chris about OCF, and our agape will be offered by Team One next Sunday. Many of our Goyans will not be in our church next Sunday because, God willing, they are being in another Holy Trinity Greek Orthodox Church in Carmel, Indiana, because the church in Carmel is organizing a basketball scrimmage for the Goyans of our area. And many of our Goyans will be there next Sunday. And talking about our Goyans, they will get together today for a meeting during the agape offered by Team 21 today. Christ is among us. God bless you. Please come for the veneration of the cross. Please stay for our agape. And